Hi, all. A lot of you have asked me where I've been on social media. I haven't been sharing very much. And the reason is that my studio has kind of exploded with all of these new ideas as a result of my residency. And I haven't really known where to start with it. The chaos is real. There's a little bit of I'm a little nervous about sharing these new ideas, but I decided today to take the plunge, to let you all in on the journey and show you my mess and take you along with me. Okay, guys, here's a little slice of some work I'm doing in the studio. My goal with these is to reflect what I see in nature. This one was hand-built from clay slabs with textures of land and sea. Here's embossed seaweed rising from the bottom of the piece and is animated with mark making and pattern all over the place. I think the final glaze colors on this one will be blues, creams, a little bit of light purple, and some greens. I'll be making changes right up to the final firing. I love the movement of layers of color sliding together and creating pattern over textures. It's really fun to drop in color and then use the spray bottle to mute the edges or merge it with other colors. It's really hard not to overdo it. I get into the dance of it. Hey, I'm just stopping in to show you guys something I made in my studio, and it's really been helpful. I had all these samples tucked away in a box, and I got them out, and I put this board together. And I can just pull them right off the wall, take them into where I'm working with some of the glazing, and these are all underglazes, and kind of see, right? I'll have this is all with my newer buff clay, and so it's giving me that real visual right in front of me, which I'm finding is really helpful. So when I'm done, I just come back and stick them back on the wall. And if I'm looking for a new color combination, I can just pull it off and take it in. So that's been a big help. Well, sometimes things happen. This is a piece that I was working on yesterday, a large vessel. It's got a lot of embossing, a lot of layering on it. And I don't know if you guys can tell right here. It started coming off one of the pieces. Now it's tempting, really tempting, just to push it, and it's way too dry for that. So I do have a solution, and I'll show you guys in a minute what I'm gonna do. I wanted to talk to you about how I resolved the problem with this vessel where the piece was popping up. I took some paper clay, made these little rectangles, and put them underneath to support it as it dries and as it fires, and it'll become part of the piece. The way that I put it on is I've used some sand that I got from Laguna that you can fire, and I mix it with some underglaze and put it along the side and a little bit underneath. So it's either going to look really good or it's going to be a disaster. Hi all, I've been working on the new vases for the nature collection. I'm making them with layers of texture and embossing with leaves and flowers. So much fun. I let them dry just long enough to hold their form. Then I prep the surface edge of both pieces and flip one side on top of the other. On this one, after I worked on the sides, I stood it up and finalized the form, added a foot for the base, and cut the opening at the top. I'm loving all the variations and all the possibilities. These will be fired soon. Stay tuned. Hi, I'm going to give you a look at my drying rack today. These are pieces that I've been working on in the last couple of days. These are done with vinyl stencils and layers of underglaze. You can see here I painted on the black, the crow, and then etched inside with my sgraffito. So there's a lot of sgraffito marks. There are these marks, these indented marks that later, after the first bis firing, I'll put on a wash of black underglaze and that'll go into those lines and really help define the shape. So I've got a whole collection of them here and they're just drying, waiting to be bis fired and then glazed. Very excited about them. Here's one, a little bit more complicated. Another crow, and he's looking over his shoulder at the quail. I wanted to talk to you about how I resolved the problem with this vessel where the piece was popping up. I took some paper clay, made these little rectangles, and put them underneath to support it as it dries and as it fires, and it'll become part of the piece. The way that I put it on is I've used some sand that I got from Laguna that you can fire, and I mix it with some underglaze and put it along the side and a little bit underneath. So it's either gonna look really good or it's gonna be a disaster. This is today's project. This is a layered wall piece, has the hole there. And what I'm gonna do now, it's been, I've embossed this plant material in it. I have fired it. And now I'm going to do an inlay of black slip. It's gonna look something like this one. Hi everybody, I am on day 12 of doing a recording every day about what I'm up to with my studio practice. And actually this morning, I was filling out a kind of a organizational chart for the Artist Accelerator group that I belong to, Allison Stanfield. And it ended up to be 4 pages of things that I do, not directly related actually to art making, everything from marketing to sales tax reports, keeping my Shopify store updated. And in fact, I was filing my sales taxes this morning. I was surprised I had forgotten about the April online event that I did. So I had to report all the sales tax on that and get them paid and that kind of thing. I am going to unload. It's still a little bit warm at about 123. I wear these gloves so that the oils from my hands won't get on the work and cause it to resist the next phase, which would be the glazing. So here we go. So today I am going to take these pieces that I pulled out of the bis kiln yesterday, and I've sanded them and washed them off really well, let that set up overnight, and now what I'm going to do is put a wash of black and then wash it away, and the black will stay in the line and hopefully won't make the rest of the pot too dark. I do want it to have kind of a weathered feel, so we'll see if this does the trick. I'm going to do several pots so you can see what that looks like. Good morning. I was going to dive right into doing glazing this morning, and I wanted to use some glazes that I don't normally use. And so I went back into all my test tiles from years ago. I still have all these. I literally have like 8 surrounding me, more on the floor, of these containers of various random test tiles. I'm sorting them through this morning. I'm finding what I like, what will work with the current work, I think. And I think is really the deal here. I need to test them again and take my time, which is not my MO, but I'm going to do it. And I'll let you guys know what I come up with. Hi, everybody. This is a tumbler, one of a collection that I got out of the bisque kiln yesterday, and I really like the way it came out. It has layers of underglaze colors, and then the black underglaze on top, and sgraffito through the whole thing. Lots of mark making, lots of interesting pattern on this set of tumblers. Right now, what you see is the application of a very thin layer of clear glaze. And I've always brushed these on because I found it gives more consistent coverage and also doesn't let it get too thick. I want it to be pretty thin on these. It'll go into the glaze firing probably later next week. And then they'll be done. Check this one out. I really like the different glazes. The matte and the gloss. Today in the studio was all about getting these tumblers done. I'm applied vinyl resist stickers that I made on my Cricut cutting machine. And I've layered them with underglazes. And so the way this works is I cut out multiples on my stick, on my Cricut, and then add them to the piece in layers in between different colors of underglaze. You kind of have to work backwards. And then after all the stickers are pulled up, I can take a look and go back into the piece, darken some areas, add sgraffito, do some line work. It's really fun. I got this one out of the bisque kiln today, and I love the way it looks. Next move will be to put a black wash of underglaze, and that will sink into the lines, and I'll wash it off, and I'll show you next what that looks like. Showing a little flashback of pieces I did last year. These are just a few of many that cover a wall of a medical facility in Riverside County. I got to meet with the art consultant that contracted with me to do that project and pick up a few extras that they didn't use for the installation. I'm really excited. We had a wonderful day. And I'm eager to bring these back to the studio and take another look. Yesterday in the studio, I worked on applying vinyls and then pulling them off. And today, I'm actually going back into these pieces and etching designs, mark making. I really take my time with this. And you can see on these finished ones, all the different ways the marks are made. I go back in with sgraffito, I carve out, I make dots. A lot of times I'll go back in and highlight some colors. I just really use it as a starting point. Here are some finished glaze pieces. Well, I got this one out of the bisque kiln the other day, and this piece right here, it had a piece that was over this that fell off. I was afraid that was going to happen, but I think in the glaze firing, I can do something interesting here with a different color, something. At least it'll be a test, you know, I'll still use it. And the other side came out pretty nice. So when this is glazed with different colors, shiny, matte, I think it'll be really interesting. And worst case scenario, it's a good way to test some glazes for the other pieces. So fingers crossed. I made this piece about a month ago. I really like parts of it. This is interesting where I embedded sand at the glazing time. Other parts I'm still looking at and it's not fully resolved. So now I'm working on some new pieces that incorporate some of that. On all of these, the rim still needs to be finished, altered, changed. You can see I've put in some embossed plant material there. These still need some of that. I'll be working on insetting some of the plant material, working on mark making, finishing the feet. These are more like sketches where I'm taking ideas and exploring more options, more ways to finish these pots. So they're filled with newspaper now as they dry. Here's one that is more finished. Well, I'm going to have my work cut out for me tomorrow. I reorganized all my clay storage because I got some new clay today and I didn't want to mix it up with this B-mix. This is all reclaimed B-mix that I'm going to put through my pugger and it'll come out as clay I can use. I'm very grateful to have a pugger, but it's still a lot of work. I am finally done. It's about, 7:30 at night, something like that. I've got everything cleaned up. I have behind me here. Maybe like 400, 500 pounds done. I didn't finish all of it. I did have to just finally say uncle, but got a good round of it done and everything cleaned up and put away. Yay! Here we go on these new forms. I'm starting to resolve some of the forms, some of the ways that I'm incorporating the feet, the rim, this rectangular vessel form. And I'm working with brand new clay to me. It's this buff that has a lot of sand. It's very craggy. It's so different than the smooth porcelain type clay I've been using in the past, which has been really good for me to try new things and to work with a lot of different experimenting. This has slabs from the embossing plates that I made from plant material. My goal is to incorporate more of that in these forms and get them further resolved today. The forms are all roughed out now, and it's time to get back to them and start the underglazing and the drawing and the incising. So that will happen today, and I hope to get these all finished up and out on the drying rack, ready to bisque fire when they get to be bone dry, and then glaze, and they'll be done.